that's the real deal right there. Look at that. It's the real thing there.
If you're that guy who stretches his games to fit a modern monitor's widescreen,
you probably know what you're doing, and obviously I don't have a problem with that.
One of the modern advantages we have nowadays is
choice.
But that same choice leads to many people not being aware of aspect ratio differences that emulators legally feed us. And I'm not talking about 4x3 versus 16x9, but about stuff more subtle than that. I'm Godi underscore, I'm a long time Twitch streamer, and I often see or help out people over there that aren't streaming at the aspect ratio they think they are. Which again, is totally fine. This is not a video about aspect ratio elitism in retro games or anything snob like that. Just a simple educational one about, at the very least, knowing which aspect ratio you're using. I own a good amount of stuff that has me geared towards real hardware setups, but I've never looked down on emulation. In fact, I'm extremely appreciative of how it's made retro gaming accessible for decades now. I still remember how somewhere in the late 90s I played through the entirety of Phantasy Star 4 for the first time on a Genesis emulator. Look at the UI, this thing was amazing. You might have had a similar experience with Nesticle back in the day, which is just as amazing of a name. In fact, they were both made by the same team. Nowadays, many emulators are packed with features and options, and usually there isn't just a single go-to emulator. Often, really good emulators or cores even will not default to 4x3. Now, I'm not here to give you specifics on those programs, though, because those change with time. I'm just gonna teach you a stupid simple method to know your current aspect ratio on the game you're emulating or playing or streaming or whatever. That way you can look into changing it if you want to. Personally, it's simple. When emulating, I like to replicate the original experience. So I just make sure that my console emulation is always at 4x3 aspect ratio, because that's what it would all stretch to back in the day on your CRT TV. This is true for NES, Master System, Mega Drive or Sega Genesis, PC Engine or TurboGrafx-16, Super Nintendo, PlayStation. Basically most of console gaming before widescreen became the standard. The reason why I'm mentioning these systems in particular though is because I know that for each of those, there are emulators that will default to a resolution different than 4x3, which whatever your preference is, generates confusion. I'm not saying it's right or wrong, I'm not telling you what to do. There's also the matter of original or internal resolution. You might know about this because of the Super Nintendo, it's got an internal resolution of 8x7. For that reason, emulators typically offer you the choice because some games might have failed to take into account the inevitable 4x3 stretch. Now, what you would get with an original hardware setup, real hardware, and a CRT is always a 4x3 aspect ratio in those cases. This is true for other platforms too, as you'll see later in the video. Again, I'm not here to tell you how you should play video games. That's ridiculous, and that kind of elitism is easily the worst thing about the otherwise excellent and tight retro gaming community on Twitch. Speaking of communities, I left a link to our Discord in the description if you'd like to hang out. So, how do you know if you're playing or streaming at 4x3 or whatever any other resolution? Easy. ShareX. ShareX is a screen capture utility I use. It's pretty good, but this is not a sponsored video. You can use any other tool to have this feature I'm gonna mention. But you'll typically have ShareX already installed, as it's very popular for screen capturing. There's like ShareX and GreenShot that are popular. You capture your region for a screenshot, and the frame selector tooltip will actually tell you how many pixels you are selecting. This is the feature. This is the video. That's the video. It's simple. You drag that around the game's box on your emulator, check your resolution, meaning the horizontal and vertical pixels, then write either of those two into calculateaspectratio.com together with the aspect ratio you're going for, and you'll see if that's correct or not. If you're streaming on hardware, then either your CRT will handle that or your upscaling devices will, if you're playing on a modern display. What you can also use this simple trick with, however, is your OBS preview if you're concerned about the aspect ratio of your stream game. So if you're streaming, I use this trick all the time even when making stream layouts. For example, I want to make sure the game area in my overlays are 4x3. I put links in the description for both ShareX and calculateaspectratio.com. While you're there, if you find this video interesting, please click like to help me make it big. You can also subscribe for more retro gaming educational videos, typically not this technical, but rather about the games themselves. Now, computer games, on the other hand, we should scratch that surface as well. Those often don't use the full estate of your old 4x3 CRT. but you can just trust your emulator of choice or Western computer games and keep those black bars at the top and the bottom edges, of course. Japanese computer games, however, are a bit less consistent on that matter, especially if you bring the Sharp X68000 computer in the mix. NEC computers like the PC88 and the PC98 series are usually fine, but a lot of stuff on the X68000 will look stretched on it. Unless you actually take off those black bars and vertically stretch the active pixel area to 4x3 yourself. It's kind of like the SNES 8x7 versus 4x3 deal. It's kind of a gray area as well, and you might just want to check game by game and choose for yourself, which is the luxury we have nowadays. And it's an option you would have back in the day too. I think in many consumer CRT sets, you can actually stretch the picture vertically or horizontally to your pleasing. Sometimes I stream Japanese exclusive computer games like those on my Twitch channel. I'm live there every Wednesday, Friday, and Sunday. There's a link in the description. Come chat. I like to talk about stuff like this, and I love old Japanese computer video games among all the other video games that I also like. This video is mostly useful for emulation, I know, but I've dropped a useful bit here and there for everyone. If it was interesting at all, please hit the like button. Ciao.
Alright, she's got a sweater.
We got a fucking nurse. I'm afraid to go on at this point.